power that is in the word of God. Nataka kuongea juu ya nguvu ambazo ziko katika neno la Bwana. Kwa sababu mambo yale ambayo Mungu anaenda kuyatenda, tutaweza tu kuyashika kama tutaelewa neno la Bwana. Praise the name of the living God. The Bible says in the book of Acts, kitabu cha matendo ya mitume, 20:32. Acts 20:32. And now, brethren, I commend you to God and to his word and to the word of his grace, which is able to build you up and to give you an inheritance among all them which are sanctified. The Bible says, the word of God is a word of grace, and the word of God is able to build you up and give you an inheritance. Can somebody declare, the word of God has the ability to build me up and give me an inheritance? Praise the name of the living God. This building up is building you in every area of your life. And this inheritance is that which God ordained for you as one of his sons. Praise the name of the living God. When I talk about sons, I'm talking about sons and daughters. Praise the name of the living God. And each one of us, we have an inheritance in God. But we can only get this inheritance through the word. Now, the person nisema, when we began this service, that a balanced church is very, very important. Some churches has a lot of word without prayer. Other churches have a lot of prayer without the word. But today to be a church that has prayer and the word combined. Bwana asifiwe sana. And let me tell you, when you understand the word of God and you are prayerful, there is no limit of what God can do in your life. Bwana apewe sifa. Mungu hutumia neno lake kufanya mambo yale yote anayotaka kufanya. Ukiangalia katika kitabu cha Genesis chapter 1, from verse 1, that talks about the beginning, the Bible says, in the beginning God created the heavens and the earth. And the Bible says, the earth was without form and void, and darkness was on the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God was hovering over the face of the waters. That is very, very important to note, that the Spirit of God was hovering over the waters. Then God said, let there be light, and there was light. You see, there are two things here. The Spirit of God was hovering over the waters, but the Holy Spirit did not act until God said, let there be. That tells you there can be an anointing upon your life. There can be an anointing upon the church. But unless there is a word that is released, the anointing cannot do anything. Praise the name of the living God. The Holy Spirit and also the ministering angels, they only respond to the word of God. They don't respond to your complaints. They don't respond to your murmuring. They don't respond to your unbelief. If you want the Spirit of God to respond, if you want the angels of God to respond, they only respond to the word of God. So you must teach yourself how to speak the word of God in every situation. Wakati dunia ilikuwa giza, ilikuwa ukiwa, Mungu hakuanza kunungunika. Sasa hii dunia na inakaa namna gani? Sasa hii giza naye ni mingi sana. Mungu hakunungunika. Mungu alisema na kuwe na kukawa. Bwana asifiwe sana. Watu wengi kukiwa na shida katika maisha yao, badala ya wanene neno la Mungu katika hiyo hali, wanaongea maneno mengi. Na unajua maneno yako na creative power. Hata maneno ambayo unaongea kinyume. When you speak negative words, the Bible says that the power of life and death is in the tongue. So hali yoyote inapotokea na unaanza kuongea maneno mengine kinyume, maneno hayo ndio yatakupatia matokeo. Ndipo sababu Biblia inasema katika kitabu cha Mithali, yule anayependa ulimi wake atakula matunda ya ulimi. Matunda ya ulimi ni kile unachonena. Ukitaka kuona nguvu za Mungu, lazima utangaze neno. Kwa hivyo Biblia inasema, and this is very important to me, because some people carry a lot of anointing, that is the Holy Spirit, but they don't have the word. Others have the word, but they don't have the spirit. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. So unakuta yule akona neno, hata akinena neno na roho hayuko, Mungu kabla hajanena, the spirit of God was there. Praise the name of the living God. So kuna watu wakona roho wa mtakatifu na nguvu na upako, lakini hawana neno. Wengine wakona neno, lakini roho hayuko. But in the beginning we see a combination of the spirit of God and of the word of God. Praise the name of the living God. The Bible says in the book of Psalms 33, verse 6, by the word of the Lord, the heavens were made, and all the hosts of them by the breath of his mouth. Praise the name of the living God. The breath of his mouth represents the Holy Spirit. That means they were created by the Lord, and he made them through, number one, the word, and number two, the breath of his mouth. Let us read verse 9. Verse 9, the Bible says, for he spoke, and it was done. He commanded, and it stood fast. Praise the name of the living God. He spoke, and when he spoke, it was done. Bwana asifiwe sana. Mungu akitaka kufanya kitu, huwa anatuma neno lake. Na akituma neno lake, linafanya kile ambacho anachotaka. Unaweza kuona hiyo katika Psalms 107 verse 20. So to God, word and deed are the same. Yani kwa Mungu kitendo na neno ni the same. He sent his word and healed them and delivered them from their destruction. He sent his word and healed them and delivered them from their destruction. If you also read the book by the Isaiah 55 and verse 11, so shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth. It shall not return to me void, but it shall accomplish what I please, and it shall prosper in the thing for which I sent it. Part B is very important. Number one, inasema, so shall by my word that goes from my mouth, it shall not return to me void, it shall accomplish what I please. So Mungu akitaka kufanya jambo, anatuma neno lake. And the Bible says, it shall prosper in the thing. That in the thing for which I sent it to do, God can send his word for different purposes. And that is why there is the word of God for every situation in your life. Because the word prospers in the thing that it was sent to do. Bwana asifiwe sana. The Bible says in the book of Amos, chapter 8 and verse 11, that in the last days there will be a hunger. Amos 8. The days are coming, declares the sovereign Lord, when I'll send a famine through the land. Not a famine of food or a thirst for water, but a famine of hearing the words of the Lord. Kama kuna kitu Mungu anataka kurejesha sasa, watu wamesikia maneno mengi ambayo haikuwasaidia. Lakini Mungu anatuma njaa na kiu cha neno lake. Kuna watu wanataka kusikia tu neno la Mungu sasa. Neno halisi, neno ambalo halijachanganywa. The pure and adulterated word of God. That is what people are desiring to hear. Praise the name of the living God. The Bible says, let the word of God dwell in you richly. David said, I have hidden your word in my heart that I may not sin against you. He said, your word is a lamp for my feet. Praise the name of the living God. May you receive the hunger and the thirst for the word of God in this season. Because God says, my word shall not return to me void. It must accomplish that purpose I sent it to do. Kuna neno limetumwa kwa ajili ya kusudi ya hali yako. Na ni vizuri kuwa na neno la hiyo hali ambayo unayoipitia. Sio kuomba tu maombi yemte. Unaomba maombi ambayo yako na neno. Roho walikuwa natembea juu ya maji na kulikuwa na giza. Unaweza kuwa na upako na roho na bado kuna giza. Bado kuna ukiwa katika maisha yako. Nyumba haina kiti. Bwana asifiwe sana. Hallelujah. Mambo mengi ni giza katika maisha yako. But the minute you start proclaiming the word of God in your situation, the word of God is creative. It has creative power. Inaweza kuumba kile ambacho hakiko. Jesus was the word of God manifested in the flesh. The Bible says in the book of John, chapter 1, from verse 1. The Bible says, in the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word was God. He was God in the beginning. Through him, all things were made. Without him, nothing was made that has been made. Without the word. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. Mambo yote yaliumbika kupitia neno lake. Nikwambia, God and his word, they are one. Na Mungu akitaka kufanya jambo lolote, anaweza kutuma neno lake liwe kama his servant li accomplish kile ambacho anataka kufanya. So word and deed are one in God. So wewe vile huwa unataka kulima shamba, unachukua jembe, unaenda unalima wiki mzima, kile kitendo cha kulima ndio kinafanya shamba yako ilimike. Lakini Mungu akitaka kulima hiyo shamba, yeye sio lazima achukue jembe alime, yeye anaweza kutuma neno. Na neno lile likafanya kile ambacho anataka katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Praise the name of the living God. Nataka tusome Romans chapter 1 and verse 16 na tujifundishe mambo kama maine pale alafu nimalize. For I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believeth, to the Jew first and also to the Greek. Mambo yale maine tunaweza angalia from that portion of scripture. Number one, Paul said, I'm not ashamed of the gospel. What is the gospel? The gospel is the good news. You know, in the world today, there is a lot of bad news. Praise the name of the living God. But there are very few people who are speaking the good news. May you be a bastender of the good news in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Mungu anataka sisi tuwe mabarozi wa habari jema. There is a lot of negative news out there. Na watu wengine wamekuwa poisoned. Na wame lose hope. Wameona kama hakuna jambo nzuri linaloweza kufanyika. But the gospel, praise the name of the living God, is the good news of our Lord Jesus Christ. So unaweza kutangazia watu wote haijalishi hali wanaopitia. Unaweza kuwatangazia habari jema ya uponyaji. Habari jema ya ukombozi. They could be in addiction. Wanaweza kuwa masikini. Unaweza kuwatangazia habari jema ya moja aliyefanyika masikini kwa ajili yao. So the gospel is a good news. And Paul said, he is not ashamed. Sometimes you can go in a situation. Na unaona vile watu wameamini hiyo hali. Lakini wewe unaaibika kutangaza neno la Mungu. Na kuwapatia habari jema. Enda ukitangaza habari jema kuanzia siku ya leo. Praise the name of the living God. But something you need to note there, he is not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. The gospel of Christ, you know, Christ is not the second name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Because some people, if they ask, they would say the second name of our Lord, Jesus Christ. But here, Christ, in Greek, it means Christos. And Christos means the anointed one. Praise the name of the living God. So, it is the gospel of the anointed one. Praise the name of the living God. The reason sometimes we are not able to declare this good news, it is because it is the good news of the anointed one. And because we have lost the anointing. And it is the good news of the anointed one. Acts chapter 10 and verse 38. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. For Jesus to declare the good news, he was to be anointed. So the gospel is a gospel of the anointed one. So without anointing, you may not be able to declare the good news. And the Bible says, in the last days, there will be perilous times, because people will have a form of godliness, but deny the power thereof. When you have a form of godliness, that means you have the word. You may have the good news, but you have denied the power thereof. So there is no anointing. And when you go back to the book of, let's go back to Romans chapter 1 and verse 16. We combine. The Bible says, it is the gospel of who? Of Christ, the anointed one. For it is the power of God. The power? Jesus was anointed with what? With the Holy Ghost and power. What is power? Power simply means the ability to get results. Praise the name of the living God. Wakati Biblia sema wewe uko na nguvu ama power, here inamaanisha the ability to get results. Jesus would get results in any situation, and he would get the kind of results that he wants. When you have the power, it means you have the ability to get positive results. Bwana asifiwe sana. Hallelujah. When you have the anointing of God upon your life, you have supernatural enablement. It is God's super ability on your natural ability. Na ningetaka kusema ya kwamba, haijalishi umesoma kiasi gani, haijalishi your status in the society, you will discover that there are things you cannot be able to achieve with your natural ability. There are things in life you never be able to achieve with your natural ability. But when you combine your natural ability with God's super ability, you walk in the supernatural. And when you walk in the supernatural, that means the anointing of God plus your natural ability, nothing will be impossible. You are going to face impossibilities, and they are going to become possibilities. Praise the name of the living God. God's supernatural power will take you from the ordinary to the extraordinary. That is why when they observed the life of Peter and John, they say these are ordinary and schooled men. But because they have been with Christ, the anointed one, they were able to turn their world upside down. Why? Because of God's supernatural ability upon their lives. That is why Jesus told them, do not leave Jerusalem until you receive power from on high. Why? Because without power, you cannot be able to get results. Many people are frustrated in ministry. They are frustrated in business. They are frustrated in many areas of life because they cannot be able to get the desired results. But with God's supernatural ability, you can get results. May God anoint you for business. May God anoint you for your career. May God anoint your natural ability, your talent, your gift. May the anointing of God rest upon you. In the mighty name of Jesus, somebody say, oh Lord, I desire the anointing and the power of the Holy Ghost upon my life. In the mighty name of Jesus. Praise the name of the living God. Let's go back to Romans chapter 1 and verse 16. We see the word salvation. The Bible says, for it is the power of God unto salvation. Praise the name of the living God. This word used here, salvation, it's not the same meaning with born again. Being born again is an act that happens once in your life. And it doesn't mean when you are born again, every sickness disappeared. Every financial problem disappeared. In fact, sometimes you get born again and you are pockets are as empty as they used to be. Praise the name of the living God. So you can be a born again who is sick. You can be a born again who is poor. But the word here, salvation, which is a process, the word here, salvation in Greek, it is sozo. S-O-Z-O. And this word sozo, it means six things that I'm going to mention. Sozo means that you have safety. Number two, sozo means preservation. You are preserved. Number three, it means healing. Number four, it means prosperity. Number five, it means soundness. And number six, it means deliverance. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. So when we talk about sozo, it means that we are living in safety. It doesn't matter how many accidents take place every day. The Lord has the ability to protect his own. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. Preservation means it doesn't matter how many attacks the enemy is launching. Praise the name of the living God. But you can be preserved in the midst of all these attacks. Praise the name of the living God. It means healing. Divine healing. It also means prosperity. It also means soundness. Soundness of mind, it means that you are thinking right. Because wrong thinking leads to long living. I don't know what I would be thinking today if I was not being directed by the word of God. So right thinking comes by believing in the word of God. And number six, it means deliverance. Praise the name of the living God. So the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, praise the name of the living God, brings salvation. And the last point is to everyone that believeth. If you don't receive it, if you don't believe it, you can't receive it. And that is why I'm saying, kama mimi singekuwa nimeamini neno la Mungu, leo sijui ningekuwa ninafikiria nini. Sijui ningekuwa ninafanya nini na maisha yangu. Because ningeamini ripoti za kule nimezaliwa, ningeamini ripoti za watu, ningeamini mambo mengi. Lakini siku ya leo kwa sababu nimeliamini neno, maisha yangu ni tofauti sana. Kuona kwangu hali na mambo ni tofauti sana. Kwa sababu sasa, mtazamo wangu wa mambo yote unaelekezwa na neno la Mungu kwa sababu nimeliamini. Na kwa sababu nimeamini neno la Mungu, limebadilisha mtazamo wangu. Na hilo neno liko na uwezo wa kunipatia wokovu. Na wokovu huo unamaanisha kwamba litaniletea ufanisi katika maisha. Litaniletea ulinzi katika maisha. Litaniletea uponyaji katika maisha. Litaniletea ukombozi katika maisha. Neno la Mungu ama injili ama habari njema inabeba kila kitu ambacho ninahitaji katika maisha yangu. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. Everything that you need for life is packed. And not only for life, even for godliness, it is packed in this word. Praise the name of the living God. Your inheritance is packed in this word. And that is why the word will prosper in the thing. The thing that God sent the word to do, there is a word sent to you for prosperity. There is a word for preservation. There is a word for healing. There is a word for deliverance. And you need to capture that word. And because you believe, you speak and declare the same word. No matter what is happening around you, you believe. And then you speak. And then you are going to see the change. Praise the name of the living God. But even as you speak, it is very, very important to understand that this good news can only manifest its power when we walk in the anointing of the Holy Spirit. Praise the name of the living God. Anointing means, if I want to anoint this podium, it is the rubbing on of oil. That is anointing. Praise the name of the living God. And the more you tally in the presence of God, the more the rubbing of the anointing continues in your life. That is why we need to create time in the presence of God. So that the rubbing of oil can continue. And the Bible says in the book of Isaiah chapter 10 and verse 27, that the yoke will be broken because of the anointing. In fact, some version says that because you have grown so fat, And it shall come to pass in that day, his burden, the burden of the enemy, shall be taken away off thy shoulder, and his yoke off thy neck. And the yoke shall be destroyed because of the anointing. The anointing breaks the yoke. The yoke is a sign of bondage. The yoke is a sign of limitation in your life. Praise the name of the living God. But the Bible says, because of the anointing, the yoke will be broken. I pray for more of the anointing of the Holy Spirit. We thank God for what you have seen in the past. But I declare more of the anointing of the Holy Spirit. Praise the name of the living God. I declare that all of you are going to be full of the Holy Ghost. Tongue speaking believers. Moving in the gifts of the Holy Spirit. Walking under the anointing and full of the power of the Holy Ghost. In the mighty name of Jesus. Bwana asifiwe sana. Magonjwa yanaweza kuwa ni mengi ambayo hayana dawa. Lakini, bado tunaweza kuamini neno la Mungu that he is a God who healeth us. Praise the name of the living God. There are two types of battles. There is the battle that we call defensive battle and the offensive battle. The defensive battle is when you defend yourself from the enemy when he has come to you. Yani unangojea, unalala, mpaka adui anaattack. Unasa, oh, wachana na mimi! Unaanza kupigana naye. Hiyo inaitagwa defensive. Lakini kuna ingine offensive. Offensive ni ile unamwambia hata kabla haujakuja ningoje. Ninakuja kwako. Praise the name of the living God. Unaenda katika marango ya adui. Unayagonga gonga. Unayangusha. Jesus said, I'll build my church and the gates of hell shall not prevail. Jesus did not say that he will build strong gates to protect us from the enemy. No. He did not say, I'll build my church and the gates I'll build for the church, the enemy will not prevail against those gates. No. He said, my church will be very strong, that my church will attack the gates of the enemy. The gates of the enemy means the powers, the machinations, the demonic strategies. You go and attack whatever the enemy is planning before he attacks you. Praise the name of the living God. Sita gojea naenda katika kambi ya adui. Haufai kugojea. Biblia inasema walipolala wakagojea. Adui akapanda magugu. Sita mgojea apande magugu. Nitaenda kuyangoa yakiwa kwa nasari. Si unajua kuna nasari huwa tunapanda boga. Ndio baadaye uihamishe uipeleke kwa shamba. Naye shetani yako na nasari zake. Zingine ni za kansa, zingine ni za magonjwa ya figo, zingine ni za kuataki biashara, zingine ni za kuwa ako na manasari tofauti. Kuna mapando anapanda pale. Anangojea kuja kuyapanda katika maisha ya waaminio. Lakini tutaenda kwa hizo nasari zote na tutaziharibu. Chochote amepanda pale anaandaa kinyume na maisha yetu, tutaenda na tuharibu katika jina Yesu Kristo. The Bible says in Matthew 15:13, kila pando ambalo sio baba amelipanda litang'olewa na misizi. Sitagojea mapando ya adui ayapande katika maisha yangu. Nitaenda kwa nasari zake, nitaharibu marango yake, nitaharibu nguvu zake. Praise the name of the living God. Whatever the Lord puts in my heart to do for his own glory, I will do it. Not because of my natural, but because the supernatural of God is upon me. There is divine enablement upon my life. Receive it in your life in the mighty name of Jesus.